the first time Christian ever spent a night in the streets, I took her here because it was an enclosed place.
You took her to this.
Inside here, they have stairs.
Yeah. Inside here, you could go, and it's like stairs, emergency stairs.
To go under, and then it's like a big hallway, and then stairs going out. But it's all closed doors. And she's never slept on the streets before, so I was like, well, I'll do one better. We'll be inside, but we don't have a bed, we don't have blankets. This is just how we're going to have to sleep.
And nobody bothered you?
No.
Do you have to sneak in?
Kind of.
But it was one security guard that didn't care. As long as she wasn't down there getting high or doing things stupid. Or she was just trying to get you to rest. He didn't care. But then I guess either he got fired or he moved or whatever. Because now you can't go over
there. Yeah, now the door is locked.
Christian, that first night, were you scared? You were sad? You were mad?
Not really.
It was life.
Honestly, like, when I moved back for my mom, after the first time I lived in the home, we only had a stable place, our own spot, until we was, like I said, until I was 13.
Yeah.
We were supposed to move to Pennsylvania. Well, when my mom got one that died, said that now, he didn't have a place. He was homeless his damn self. You know, out here getting high for him. He didn't have no kids and none of that, so he was just partying. He was a party dog, you know?
Yeah.
So, I stayed with her for like probably 6-7 months after that, and we was just going from house to house, all her friends' houses that they'll let us come stay tonight. And then sometimes I'll go to my cousin's house, and then I'll go back with my mom. So technically, we was homeless.
Yeah.
Didn't really have nowhere to stay. At one point in time, when I was with my mom, and my stepdad, we had to ride the bus all night.